Goodbye, OBC. Though I never knew you at all, you made the game fun to follow, and I hear you threw a good ball. Won the ACC in Durham. You were trolling even then, posing underneath a scoreboard at an away game rivalry win. And it seemed to be you coach your life with a visor in your hand. We never knew if you might strike a ref or strike up the band. And I don't know if I could have played for you the times you look so mad. But then again, those times you'd win, it didn't look so bad.
That last thing about Georgia having players suspended, and I said, well, I like playing them early because I always got some guys suspended. The week of the game, nobody even brought it up.
Goodbye, OBC. You always gave us A-plus quotes. The parents of the press conference had us ready to take notes. So long, OBC. You gave Peyton Manning so much hell that we almost forgot about that stop you had in the NFL. And it seemed to me you coached your life with a microphone in your hand. Always wanted to have the media at your command. And I don't know if I could have covered you the times you looked so mad. But then again, those times you'd grin, you didn't look so bad.
We had a big win over that team from the upstate recently. We were able to beat Wofford 24-7. They didn't give us a trophy for beating Wofford. We had to beat that other team.
Goodbye, OBC. You were the best coach at three different schools. I hear you even invented Gatorade or something like that, and it only adds to your fame. Even at age 70, some fans could see you as more than a coach. They'd see you as something sexual. But for me, it was all about the game. And it seemed to be you coached your life with a visor in your hand. Never know if you might hit a kid or strike up the band. And I don't know if I could have played for you all the times you look so mad. But then again, those times you'd win didn't look so bad.